Well, we got a wicked windy night going on here tonight. Big weather changes coming, so I'm sure it's going to start getting real cold in a hurry here. That's usually what happens this time of year. So tonight we are just continuing on with this sawmill base, trailer, whatever you want to call it. In the end, it will end up being a sawmill trailer. It is really ripping out there tonight. So anyway, I'm starting to wonder, sooner or later, you guys are going to learn to find out that I'm just some nutsack up here full of shit running a camera. And I really don't know what I'm talking about, but boy, we try to pretend real hard, don't we? But anyway, so what we got going on tonight? I've got the frame set up on blocks. We have everything leveled out really well. That's the big thing, the real important thing here. Now, I'm not going on any basis of knowing anything about building a trailer. I'm totally winging it here. And we're just going to see how it turns out. It's either going to work or it's not. But honestly, I don't think we're going to have an issue with as heavy built as this thing's going to be. But anyway, I can tell you from the viewpoint of owning a sawmill for a few years now, running one quite a bit, and anything that's twisted, it's not going to work for you. You get any kind of twist in there, and every timber you cut, every board you cut, is going to be out of whack. You're going to fight it. You're going to hate it. It'll ruin the whole experience for you. That's why it's so important to get a decent base on your sawmill. Wherever you set that thing up, get a good base under it, whether it's concrete or whatever you need to do. Wooden bases on piers do not always work very well for very long. A lot of times you're going to find that you have to go through, re-level everything, all that good stuff. Now with this thing, we're still going to have to level it. It's still going to want a twist on it because it is just a big metal frame. You're going to have a lot of weight on it, so there's going to be stresses, and depending on where you park this thing, just from the axles alone, you may develop some twists. So that's why you're going to need leveling jacks of all kinds here, which we'll get to that down the road as we go. Wow. This crap needs to stop. It's driving rain. Driving rains here suck because I can find every spot in the building that needs to get sealed up better. But anyway, let's get to it. So if you folks recall when I was talking about this channel iron, how it's all got a good bow in it. No crowns, but it's all nice and bowed. And I believe that is mostly because what they were using it for in their storage rack. So we've got to come up with a way to spread these. Now when I welded up these corners here, I made it so the bows were inside, so they point in. Because my way of thinking on, I figured it'd be a lot easier to push them out than to try to pull them in with ratchet straps, things like that. So what I have is might be a little sketchy seeming, but I have a 4-ton bottle jack and a piece of square stock flared on one end. I'm kind of hoping it works. We're gonna try it out. Nothing to lose but our teeth, right? That's as the saying goes. But so it's enough of a bow on these to where this end right here, I have 56 1/4 inches between the corners. Same thing on the other end. You come this way about 2 feet, we're off by about 1/8 of an inch. You get to the middle, you're off over 1/4 of an inch, and then it starts going back the other way as you get towards the other corner. Kind of what I'm hoping to be able to do here is start on this end, work my way down with the cross rails or cross members, whatever you want to call them, and kind of spread that out. So that's what we're doing tonight. This is an experiment, so let's see what develops. So I don't know if this is going to work. We're going to give it a shot. Got to spread this one pretty decently. One thing I worry about doing this, for one, doing this alone is going to be kind of a pain. But that's life in general. So I'm going to move this thing up here a little bit. This ought to be interesting. Talk about top strange ideas, but hydraulics are a wonderful thing. Now, trying to hold everything in place, of course, I probably could grab a couple clamps, but who wants to do that? When you can struggle, swear, and scream. Try to get this as centered as possible on here. I don't want to create a situation where that's going to pop up and off. We kind of want to be fairly gentle with this. Well, you guys know what they say, almost only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades, right? Well, it took a little bit of coaxing, and I had to move the jack down a little bit more towards the middle. I think I've got to get some more fluid in it. The only part that'll irritate me now is when I get this thing all the way down and it falls right through the bottom. I think it's time to take the jack out before that prophecy comes true. Actually didn't work out too badly, really. Okay, so what you guys are watching is actually footage that I shot that about 1.5 weeks ago. All this footage is in the last couple weeks. I've been working out of town again, if you guys are wondering what's going on with the video outlook. So we're actually quite a bit farther on it at this point right now. I have more footage to edit. I'm actually tearing apart an old camper behind the barn that I was going to use as the sawmill trailer. But I decided against it because this channel iron came along, but then I got pricing out trailer axles, and the cheap scrounge in me decided that those camper axles would be perfect for this project, especially since they have electric brakes already.
And also the tongue off of that camper, I think it's a 16,000 pound tongue, I believe. And the axles are rated, I want to say they're 3,500 pound axles, maybe a little heavier than that. So we're looking to make this pretty darn beefy. I plan on my wheel wells for this. I actually plan on using the 6-inch channel iron as well, because we're going to end up, you're going to be rolling logs over the sides and things like that, and you really don't want to be crushing your tires and all that good stuff. So we have a lot of stuff left to build on this. I'm thinking at this point, I'm trying to figure out where I want to put the axles in relation. I mean, this trailer is going to end up being 21 or 22 feet long, so I have to make sure I set those axles right so I get a good balance of tongue weight and weight on those axles. Now, I can offset a lot of that weight with just the sawmill head when I'm going down the road. I could probably have the sawmill head right over top of the axles. But also keep in mind that I will be using this thing to haul the log arch and the four-wheeler on it as well. That's why it's so much wider than the actual sawmill itself. All in all, this is going to be a pretty handy device. It's going to be a real game changer. Where you guys see me welding right now, I actually have all the cross members in for this back section of the trailer. I have a section of the sawmill track welded to the top at this point. So hopefully we can make some progress. Hopefully the out-of-town phone stops ringing, because I tell you what, it's making it for a long, long year this year to get anything done at home. Now, I know the rest of this week I'm about 3 hours from home and driving it every day. So that makes for some long, long days. But it beats being unemployed any day of the week. And I do have a good job, so I guess I really can't complain too much. But I look at this footage. I just had this barn cleaned out pretty nice not too long ago. Boy, it does not take me long to destroy it again. But that's the way she goes when you work a lot. You make a mess and you don't have time to clean it up. Story of my life. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I think this is a good point to cut it out here. And I will see you on the next one.